All right, good morning. Thank you for joining us again today. Thank you to all of those who are watching online this morning. We wanted to provide you some additional information about decisions that were made over the weekend and the upcoming week ahead, and so we can update families on that as well. So as you know, I stood before you about 5 days ago last Wednesday, many of you discussing how we were moving probably towards NTI, and that was as a result of continued increase, especially in employee cases and the amount of employees, especially teachers, that were being quarantined or isolated as a result of a positive COVID test. Those numbers continued to increase through last week. You know, it's been a long weekend over the weekend as we have been evaluating the numbers. It's been kind of an excruciating time because without a doubt, we have wanted and tried every single day to keep our kids in-person learning as much as absolutely possible. But as we continued to evaluate the situation yesterday and the numbers continued to increase, and especially the number of uncovered subs, teachers that did not have subs in the classroom, and an increase in the amount of central office staff that we were sending to schools to cover for those teachers. It was really becoming a difficult situation, beyond difficult situation for our schools and our staff to continue to hold classes in a safe and efficient manner each and every day at school. You know, last Thursday, I think we nearly had 600 uncovered subs. This previous Thursday, and those numbers seem to continue to increase. Each and every day last week that we were in, Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday, the number of staff absences increased significantly each and every day. And the trend was continuing, that trend line was continuing into this week. So we did have to make a very difficult decision to move to NTI, non-traditional instruction, for this week. Our schools have been preparing. In mid-December, we challenged our principals and our schools to make sure we were prepared to do this. With Omicron coming, we knew there was a potential and a possibility for that to happen. As cases have exploded here locally and across the nation, as you know, last week we talked to you about the probability of having to use NTI. And so we wanted our schools to be prepared to get our students ready. They've been doing that, but we did want to give Monday today for final instructions for schools to get out communication to staff and families. So as you know, today is a non-attendance day for students. Our schools are communicating with students and families today to make sure that they are ready to go tomorrow. Now, our move to NTI is different than, we'll say, the other two times when we started in NTI. In April of 2020, it was a brand new deal for our teachers to figure out how to teach remotely. There was no doubt about it. The learning curve was significant at that time for all of us. You know, most students didn't have devices at that time, and it was very challenging to begin and many asynchronous instruction during that time. When we went into the 2020-2021 school year and started in NTI, that was a challenge as well, because our teachers didn't really know our students at that time. And obviously we were expecting a long-term NTI period during that time. This is much different. Our teachers and our staff and our schools know our students very well. This will be short-term, non-traditional instruction. So we will have non-traditional instruction this Tuesday through this Friday. That will be 4 days of NTI. That we are prepared and will move into, and we can expect and we believe our teachers, our schools are ready and will provide great instruction for our students this week. Monday is Martin Luther King Jr. Day, as we all know, so that's a non-attendance day a week from today. And so our hope and desire is that we will come back on Tuesday a week from tomorrow, which will give all of those staff in our schools 11 days between the last day of school and next Tuesday, which will give an opportunity, as I said last Wednesday, for staff that are positive to clear quarantine and isolation and be able to return. But during that time, we'll be monitoring that situation closely as possible. You know, we want to do everything during this time to support our students, but once again, this is short-term NTI that has been provided to us by the General Assembly. Now, I want to be clear about where we stand on this in regards to the days that we have remaining with non-traditional instruction currently. I talked about this last Wednesday when I stood in front of you, but I want to reiterate this as well. The General Assembly last September granted each school district in the Commonwealth of Kentucky 10 non-traditional instruction days, which has been used for about the past 7, 8, 9 years, traditionally for weather purposes, but we are allowed to use that for COVID-19 mitigation and NTI. So these are days that are granted to us. We have 10 of those days. That is our only option at this point. We are now using 4 of those days this week, which will leave us with 6 remaining NTI days as we move into middle to late January. We know that these numbers continue to increase each and every day. We are hopeful that we are about to hit the peak of the surge, but we know medical experts are telling us that that will most likely be mid to late January. So we have 6 days remaining. If we use those 6 days at any time from that point on, each and every day that we will be have to use to be out because of COVID, they would not be NTI days. We would add those on to the end of the year in June. So you can see the difficulty and challenge that we are facing. We have to have 1,062 hours in by June 30th. So we have 10 NTI days as of this point right now. We will use those if we need them. Once again, we're using 4 this week. I want to reiterate, there are only 6 more that we can use in JCPS. So this is not long-term or unlimited NTI like it has been in the past. Our intention and goal will be to return to classes next Tuesday. As far as an overview of NTI, our teachers are ready. Our kids have devices. If families need devices, they can contact their schools today. But in the past 21 months, the technology outlook in JCPS and across the country, but specifically for JCPS, has changed significantly. So many kids now have access to those devices, have access to the internet, are very familiar with work on Google Classroom, and the ability for non-traditional instruction. Schools will be getting out schedules to their families today so that we can begin to move right into tomorrow seamlessly and make sure that we have the best and most effective non-traditional instruction for our students throughout this week. A couple of other important announcements that I think are we want families to know. First of all, curbside meal distribution will be available for families at our schools during NTI the rest of this week. Meals will be available Tuesday and Thursday at select schools from 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. You can go to our website to find those schools that are providing those curbside meals for our families. Athletics and extracurricular activities will continue during NTI as long as staffing is available. Once again, we are in the NTI. I want to be clear about this. Because of the lack or our inability right now to cover classrooms because of how many teachers we have out at this time. But extracurricular activities will go on as long as COVID safety measures are followed and we have the appropriate staffing to cover those activities. We'll also have support for English language learners, and counseling support will be available to students during NTI as we have always done that. Those are some of the big steps that we will take. Once again, from last Thursday, which was our last day in school, until next Tuesday will be 11 consecutive days and give our students the opportunity, our staff the opportunity to clear that quarantine and that isolation. You know, I'll say this again, once again, these have been very difficult decisions. It's been difficult times, obviously, across our community and our nation, but in education more than ever. This is a struggle through districts everywhere right now as we are struggling, just like so many other corporations and entities, to staff our schools effectively. There is that very difficult balance in definitely wanting to get our kids in school, but also making sure that we are able to do it safely. We are able to do it effectively so that kids can learn and we can provide instruction. and not to put too much stress on our schools who are trying and our leaders, you know, in very innovative ways to make sure that we are covering all classes with the amount of substitutes we have out right now. So very difficult challenges and very difficult times for us. But as always, I know JCPS staff and students will step up. We're going to provide great instruction during NTI, and we plan on being back hopefully a week from tomorrow back to in-person learning. I'm happy to take any questions that you have at this time.
Dr. Pollio, the only question I really have is, why wait until Sunday evening, 6 o'clock, to make this decision? Was there something, you know, were you holding out hope Saturday and even Friday night that maybe you could squeeze in a day this week in person?
Well, it was pretty clear last Wednesday about the process that we go through, and it's been no different. And the process is we gather in mid-afternoon, just like we do during the weekday, to evaluate the numbers. And I know that's difficult and challenging, but we are trying to get every possible day of in-person instruction that we have, because once again, we only have 10 NTI days. So we gathered on Saturday to monitor the data. We were continuing to see the numbers increase throughout the weekend. So going into the weekend, we had hopes that we could go today, tomorrow. Being very candid with you, it was probable that we were going this, that we would be transitioning to NTI early this week, whether it was Monday, Tuesday, or Wednesday, just based on the trend data and the line of the amount of absences we have. When we have a staff member who tests positive, they are quarantined or isolated for 10 days at this point. So it's not like they're coming back. But going Friday into Saturday, you know, we felt like it was possible we would have the numbers, but we were going to have to make that final decision on Sunday. The numbers continued to increase dramatically as Sunday went along, and we were forced to make that call.
Dr. Pelley, do all the students have their Chromebooks and basically all the essentials they need? I know those were handed out last year. Do they still have them to kind of move forward?
So most of our students do have those Chromebooks and things. That's one of the main reasons we wanted to make sure we had today as an opportunity for students to reach out to their school if they needed to get something. Our principals, assistant principals, the administrators are working at schools today, so it gives the opportunity to get out final schedules, and if students have something that they need, they can reach out to their schools and get it, but the vast majority of our students have what they need to be successful with NTI.
Dr. Pollio, if the staffing shortage forces JCPS to extend NTI beyond the number of days approved by state lawmakers, what's the penalty?
What's the penalty?
Yes.
There's not necessarily any penalty that we would have. If we go beyond, once again, we have 10 NTI days. So that is the maximum amount of days at this time we can use for non-traditional instruction. Every day after that that we are forced to be out of school because of staffing, we will add on to the end of the school year, and we will go to school as long as it takes in June.
I just wanted to ask, Eileen with Spectrum News One Kentucky, you've mentioned a few times that you hope to be back. You hope to be back hopefully on next Tuesday. So what do those numbers have to look like in order for school to be back?
Well, the difficulty in this, is it Eileen?
Yes.
That what you said? I'm sorry, Eileen. Yeah. The difficulty in this, Eileen, is that there is no formula that says exactly when we will or will not return. We have to look at a couple things. We look at the total number of absences that our staff have. We look at the important number for us is uncovered subs or uncovered classrooms. We don't have subs to cover those classrooms. But on top of that, you know, the challenge for us right now is there is no mechanism for individual schools. So, you know, we have some schools that may be lower in their need, but we have other schools, high schools and middle schools especially, that may have had 15, 16, 18 uncovered classrooms, which becomes untenable at that point to figure out ways to do that, and especially when we've reduced the pool of subs who are available and reduced the pool of central office folks who can go out to schools and cover. So those were growing over the weekend as well, so that's what you know, that major challenge was. So, you know, we have to meet, we have to look at all of those figures and make a determination. The schools that have the highest impact of COVID, can we cover them? You know, can we send out enough staff to make sure that we can operate safely? And if we can't, then we have to make that difficult call.
So I know the announcement for NTI came yesterday. So do you expect that the announcement for whether you're going to go back on Tuesday will come on Monday, or are you planning earlier? What does that look like in terms of when it will come?
Well, we'll continue on with the same process, which we have talked about, and I know that makes it difficult, but we've got to make informed decisions based on the data that we have. And so as substitutes or as teachers call in for sick, testing positive over the weekend, you know, we have to make those decisions based on the data that we have. So we will do the exact same thing next weekend. As we go into the weekend, we'll meet the leadership team on Friday to look at numbers at that time, to look at concentration of staff in schools, how many are out, how many of our staff have cleared isolation or quarantine as a result of the 11 days away. We'll meet again on Saturday, we'll meet Sunday, and we'll meet Monday. And so we would like to be able to make that decision, but our number one goal here is to make the right decision that we can do so that, you know, we can have school safely. So I would anticipate a Monday decision. Kevin?
You mentioned last week that you were wanting lawmakers to give you all more flexibility with NTI. One of the bills moving through the legislature now is would give school districts 10 days per school to implement some sort of targeted remote learning. Is that something that you've talked to people in Frankfort about in terms of your support, or what sort of difference that can make with the district, and what do you think about that proposal and what it could do for JCPS?
Well, I think there is some potential to help with that. I do have some concerns about a school district with 155 schools trying to surgically figure out ways to close certain schools and not others, and what that level is. So example, school A has 15 uncovered classrooms and school B has 8 or 9 uncovered classrooms, and trying to make a decision, one stays in school and one goes to remote learning. Those would be very difficult decisions. And like I said, there is no exact science or data to this to say this is exactly when we should close. I am hoping, you know, my hope and desire would be that those 10 remote days, if a district has used their 10, that we could then transition those into 10 more NTI days. And then I believe we would have enough to make it through this Omicron surge. I'm hoping, you know, once again, I've said this many times up here, I'm no epidemiologist or expert, I follow like everybody else does. I'm hoping that at least for this school year, this is the end the last surge that we will face this year after Delta and Omicron, and then we can finish the year in person, which is our absolute desire to do that. So I would like to see those 10 remote days. If we've used 10 NTI days, we could then transition those into full 10 NTI days. But I want to say this, I will not push, and I am not looking for unlimited NTI days. We want our kids in school. We need our kids in schools, but we do need to have some flexibility, especially over the next 3 weeks, as we know this is going to be a difficult time.
Minute detail question. Will students have to make up today at the end of the year?
That will be up to our board. As I said last Wednesday, we have 4 days. JCPS goes 4 days over the required number of hours for our required by state law by June 30th. So we can ask our board to forgive this day, but it will be up to, and I'll make a recommendation at that time. The two options would be our board forgives the day, or the second would be added on to the end of the year or another day that we are off school. So I'll discuss this with our board and see what their belief would be. But if we forgive Friday and forgive today, our board does that, then we would only have 2 of those days remaining.
Okay.
Thank you all. Have a great day.